ngayong gabi, ako po ay nandito bilang National Chairman ng National Federation of Filipino-American Associations, ang pinakamalaking koalisyon ng mga asosasyon ng Pilipino sa Amerika at saka mga advocacy groups. Meron po kaming 12 regional chapters all over the United States. May opisina po kami sa Washington, D.C. Kapag ka may issue tungkol sa Asian Americans o Filipino Americans sa White House o sa Congress, kami po ang pinatatawag. At kailan po lamang, last week, ninombrahan po ang aming National Vice Chair, si Rosita Lee, na member ng White House Advisory Commission for Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders. Dalawa po mission ng NAFA. Ang una, itaguyod ang kapakanan ng mga Pilipino sa Amerika. Ang pangalawa, ang tulungan ng Pilipinas, pagkat mahal po namin ang aming bayan. Kahit marami po sa amin ay matagal na rito at halos dito na rin lumaki. We spearheaded the lobbying efforts for the Veterans Equity Bill in cooperation with the Philippine Embassy. When Filipino doctors were insulted in the TV show Desperate Housewives, kami po ay nagmartsa, nagdemonstrate. We demanded an apology from ABC Network and got the apology. Kailan po lamang ay nasa mainstream media kami, pagkat binugbog namin si Floyd Mayweather dahil sa ininsulto niya si Manny Pacquiao, at hindi lamang si Manny Pacquiao, kundi ang buong Pilipinas. Kaya po ako narito ay para iparating sa inyo na kami po sa NAFA ay nasa likod ninyo, nasa tabi ninyo, nasa ilalim ninyo sa pagtaguyod ng kapakanan ng Pilipinas dito sa Amerika. Tumulong po kami para kayo magwagi. Gusto po namin kayong tulungan para magtagumpay. I also have a personal stake in your success. You may not know this, but I helped you win. Or maybe more accurately, I helped make your opponent lose. You can ask Johnny Santos about it.
Let me just tell everybody, you know, he was the one who coined the Villarroyo slogan, and Johnny and the others who used that acknowledged that it was Greg who came up with that brilliant slogan during the election campaign.
At any rate po, alam po namin nagtitipid po kayo sa biyaheng to. Hindi po lamang sa pamamagitan ng pagkain ng hotdog sa Manhattan, kundi pati na rin sa gastos tungkol sa inyong pag-PR. Sa totoo po, sa larangan ng US Advertising and Public Relations, ang $15,000 ay misto lang bumili lamang kayo ng hotdog sa Manhattan. Ni hindi makabili ng isang 30-second spot sa network television. Sa America's Funniest Video, one 30-second spot costs $75,000. Sa Desperate Housewives, $285,000. And yet, marami hong nanganchaw sa inyo. Obviously, hindi na naintindihan kung gaano kahalaga ang pagpapalaganap ng kaalaman at informasyon tungkol sa mabubuting nangyayari sa Pilipinas. Kaya ako po nasabi yan, sapagkat ako din po ay isang journalist. Kolumnista po ako ng Business World sa loob po ng 22 taon. At saka 50 taon na po akong advertising and public relations practitioners. Mas buhay pa ako bago mabuhay itong mga nandito. Kami pong nasa Amerika ay nakahandang tumulong sa inyo. At kami po ang maaaring pinaka-epektibong communications vehicle para sa inyo at para sa Pilipinas. Kami hindi lamang sa Amerika, buong overseas Filipinos. Ang importante po lamang na dapat alam namin kung ano ang aming sasabihin. Sa totoo po, hindi po namin alam. Mas marami kaming nababalita ang masama kaysa sa mabuti. Kagabi po, nandoon kami sa Field Dev Gala at marami kayong binigay ng magagandang balita noon lang namin nadinig. Sayang po kung hindi madidinig ng buong mundo. Kami po ay may proposal, mawalang galang po, ayon namin kayong pangunahan, kung paanong magagawa ng paraan para magkaroon ng effective, sustained overseas information and communications program upang hindi lamang ang masamang balita tungkol sa Pilipinas, kundi ang napakaraming magagandang balita, lalo na yung inyong ginagawa, ay malaman ng lahat. Hindi lamang ng mga Pilipino, sapagkat yan ay dinadala ng GMA Network at TMC, kundi the mainstream media and the mainstream publics, businessmen, the academe, think tanks, media, and the average American whose opinion counts in the halls of Congress. I have here, Mr. President, a proposal for a Bureau of Overseas Information and Communications in the hope that your government will give due importance to this aspect of government operations, because without meaning to be disrespectful, over the years, the function of overseas information and communication has not been given enough importance. In fact, even in a premier outpost like the United States, that function has been handled as a secondary function by a member of the consulate, a consul, not even a professional communications man. And this is because of the lack of budget. Kami po libre, kaming mga Pilipino sa Amerika at sa buong mundo. Nandito po, mamahal na po.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Greg. I just want to add also that when, you know, one of the things we pledge to do is that anytime there is a bill in Congress that will affect the Philippines in a bad way, we will lobby our members, the senators and congressmen and women, because we are voters in the U.S. too. So if the Schumer bill that will affect the number of call centers in the Philippines that might put out of work 50,000 people gets the Senate, we will be campaigning all over the country to make sure that that bill doesn't pass, just as we did with CalPERS and we did with the Andean tuna issue. So that's what our pledge is. Our last speaker will talk about what we're working on also is to get Medicare transportable to the Philippines so that retirees in the U.S. can go to the Philippines, and we want to do that so that tourism will increase. And briefly to talk about it is Eric Lachica, who's been lobbying in the U.S. Congress for this.
Good evening, Mr. President. My name is Eric Lachica. As the son of a Filipino World War II veteran and the executive director of our coalition, we'd like to express, you know, our thanks to, you know, our friends in the Philippines for helping us in the United States Congress, and especially our National Federation and our allied organizations here in the United States. The good news is we won more than $200 million for our Filipino World War II veterans, which President Obama released last year, thanks to the leadership of also Ambassador Ga. So I'd like to say that I know last Thursday evening, Ms. Loida Lewis gave a wish list of items, and one of them was the requesting your assistance in talking to President Obama about extending Medicare coverage to the Philippines. I was wondering, I just heard that you had 7 minutes, I believe, last Friday with President Obama. Would it be appropriate to ask you what you discussed about that conversation? Maraming salamat.
Okay, thank you. And now is the time for the President to give his remarks to us. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Rodriguez. I'll answer the last question first. Baka I might miss some, no? Sorry, medyo marami ho kayo nagsalita. At nakasikwenta na ho kami lakad. Okay, I think I was the only one given, apart from the ASEA, di ba, we had the joint thing, and we talked. Then I approached it in this manner. President Obama has so many things on his table, on his plate, rather. Yes. And how would that be a good marketing ploy on my part to ask him about extending Medicare benefits when one of the problems is his healthcare reform? Ibang, di ba? Sino man sa atin, lalapitan mo, dadagdagan mo yung problema, tapos may papakiusap ka, parang wrong timing yata yan. Yeah. However, he did promise me that there will be a more extended bilateral. I don't know, baka that might happen, might join us sa Hanoi, there's an ASEAN meeting. Wala pa hong firm. But the bottom line is he did grant us that, and there were several more senior members of the ASEAN in attendance who also were trying to angle for the time. what I discussed with him was a more immediate concern. There is a, for want of a better phrase, there's an ammo dump. It's off corridor. It used to contain over 400,000 pounds of explosives, and it is in a deteriorated condition. There's a danger of portions of it exploding, and there'll be sympathetic detonations, 20 kilometers ang blast area. Now, the Ambassador Thomas is working with us on that. There's a problem with funding, and they were projecting 2 years. So I appealed that. Two things, either take care of it or reauthorize us to take care of your property and dispose of it properly. You cannot do it, syempre, in the ocean. You cannot do it in Manila Bay. You just, matinding blast fishing ho yun. The island is too small. You cannot destroy it on site. You might precipitate the sympathetic detonations. Parang most immediate might be Crow Valley, which means you have to transport it through populated areas. Okay. Now, can I respond to the other items? No?
Yes.
Okay. Yung improvisation about returning to the Philippines. If I remember the debate centered on something like this, eh, pwede ba namamangka sa dalawang bangka?
Ilog.
Hindi, dalawa raw sasakyan eh. Dalawa direksyon. Yung concept po kasi, pag medyo tagalig yung direksyon ng isa, lipat din sa kabila. Di ba? So, or mas maganda sa kabila, o lipat naman dito. So, when you have a right, there is a concurrent duty. Di ba? Para fair lang naman eh. Oh. Pag nag-desisyon tayo lahat sa isang bagay, sumamalalo ang Pilipinas, baka hindi na namin kayo makita. Yung kabila naman, sila sa, di ba parang pare-pareho tayong bangkaro dapat. No? So, it might be difficult to say, di ba, Filipinos who are overseas or settled abroad have X rights na para may plus with less responsibilities or duties or yung ability to face the consequences. So, we can amend it. No? Any law made by man can be amended by man. However, we have to offer a different proposal to how does one signify that there really is an interest, no? To bear the full brunt of responsibilities and duties at some point in time. Of course, the citizen there does not promise 3 years from now, oh, kasama na ako sa problema. Kasama ka na sa problema. So we're open, no? Give us the ideas, and we will champion it. No? So long as, di ba? You understand, everybody has to be equal, okay? Yung sa communications naman, yung interaction, knowing what to do. We really are in the process. There's a communications group, no? We divided it into a messaging group and the one that actually delivers, the operations group for the messaging. They're supposed to be online. Kaya lang yung iniwan ho sa amin kasi lahat na, yung server, yung architecture, yung hardware, ganyan. Nung araw ho yata walang puwapansin eh. Ngayon, marami po apansin na yung babate, pupuri, gusto maalama kung ano yung nakalagay doon sa gazette, yung report ng independent committee na pinimbestigan natin kanina ng grandstand, madalas na-overwhelm yung site. Sa, hindi naman ano may tawag doon, denial of service. Kaya lang talaga kung ang daming gusto makaalam. So, ina-improve natin yan. And that is the most immediate. No? Si Dinky talks to all of the NGOs also. She might be the point person. But at the end of the day, my comm group tells me these are the feedbacks. No? Then we try to respond to everybody. For instance, I don't remember the name of the person anymore, but there's an alleged person who wrote so many criticisms, and at the end of it says, I intend to continue supporting you. So, ang tingin ko lang doon, parang hindi, talagang wala akong sinabi maganda eh. So, hindi logical. Labo mo, sa dulo, but I'll still support you. Yeah, so yeah, malabo ko, malabo yung katabi ko, malabo yung nasa likod ko, malabo yung nasa harap ko. So may dudo kami kung tunay o hindi. Pero sinagot ko na rin on a point-by-point basis.